Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to use a PSP emulator on your Android device in 2024. The best one still is PPSSPP emulator. I'm going to show you where to get it, how to set it up to play 60 frames per second on a mid-range phone and how you can get your games on it, okay? If you like tutorials that like this, don't forget to subscribe and let's get into the video. Okay. So the first thing we need to do is download the application PPSSPP PSP Emulator. You can find it in your App Store or you can go to Google, write down PPSSPP and download the application from the official website. I suggest you download it here from the official website because sometimes the applications get removed on the Play Store and then you lose your application. So I suggest you download it here. You can download it for free. The gold version doesn't have any extra options, it just means you are supporting the developers. So if you want to support the developers, you're always welcome, they're doing great work. And like this, you download the application and install it on your mobile smartphone, okay? Once you have done this, you open up the PPSSPP PSP emulator that you just installed, you press it, turn around the phone, okay? Now, if you want to play with the controller, first of all, just connect it with Bluetooth. In this case, it's a PS4 controller. This is an original one. I just modded it myself. You press this button and this one, and then you can connect it with Bluetooth. And if you're using a PS5 controller, it's also the PlayStation button and this button until it starts blinking very fast. And then you can connect via Bluetooth and the application will recognize it automatically. Okay? Okay. Now the first thing, once you have installed this application, yeah, you have to go to settings. There are a couple things we need to do here. When you're on your settings, you can see Vulkan, you leave it like this, and then you see your rendering resolution. In my case on this phone, this is a OnePlus 3CE or something. I'm using 4x PSP rendering resolution. It means the graphics are a lot sharper and much better than it was originally on the PSP and on your beautiful mobile screen. We use 4x PSP. If you have a high-end phone like Samsung S22 3 or 4 Ultra or something, you can use 8x PSP. You will get much higher graphics. But note, most of the games on the mid-range phone will work with 4x PSP. If you go up, you have better graphics, but it may lag. If you see it lagging, you can just change it in-game. So that's very nice. We'll keep it on 4x PSP. Then you have the V-Sync and full screen. I suggest you, if they're not automatically on, to turn them on. V-Sync means you will have less stripes on your screen. Okay. Frame skipping, you don't need to do that. This is to let it lag a little less, but then it will look choppy, so I wouldn't do that. I suggest you just put your rendering resolution down if it's too buggy. Okay. Then we have hardware transform, software skinning, you just keep them on, they will be on automatically. Anisotropic filtering. Anisotropic filtering. Yeah, the anisotropic filtering, I have it on 8, it works fine for me. If it's too much, you can put it on 4. And you will have better textures around your graphics. Okay, so this is also one that takes a lot of energy from your phone. If 8 is too much, just put it on 4 and you will still have very nice graphics to play a lot better than on your PSP. And if you want to see the frames per second so you can see if it's performing well or not, you can use show FPS counter. I like to use it so I know how it is performing. Note that some games natively just support 30 frames per second, like some fighting games or some racing games, but most other games you can get up to 60 frames per second. Okay, you can also write show speed and debug overlay, but this is not needed. Then we are going to our controls. In this case, you see our controller is already connected and you can see it. If I use this touchpad on the controller, you can see it's connected like a mouse. Okay, here you can press control mapping. And then you can press auto configure, and it will tell you what is connected. In this case, my wireless controller touchpad, and I can auto configure it because it is known to the application, and most controllers will work like this. okay, then we press back, press again, voila. And here you have your audio settings. You can set the stuff in if you want to alter your sound, but out of the box it works, right? Okay, now we have set up our application, our controller is connected, and now we want to put some games on it. Now the games, the game backups, you can get them online. Just write PSP ISO and you will get a lot of websites on Google where you can get the games from. And once you have the games, you have to put them on your drive in your phone. You can also immediately download it on your phone. Yeah. And in my case, I will show you, I made a map here called ROMs. Yeah, so I put all the PSP ROMs in this folder. When I open this folder, you see PSP, and here are all my ROMs. So I'm gonna press use this folder and allow. And now he will load up all the games that are in this folder. Yeah, now if I press one of these games, the game will start. But before that, I want to tell you something else, which is important. When you download the games, most of the times it's not an ISO file, it will be a 7-zip or something. And you need to extract it first and import the ISO file. So if you download it and it's not the ISO file, you will get this message, like Grand Theft Auto Vice City Stories, it's a 7-zip file, you see? To open this up, you will have to go to your internal file manager, and there you can unpack it. Once you unpack it, it will be ISO and your application will recognize it if you don't download them immediately in ISO, okay? If you download it on the PC, just unpack them beforehand and then put them on your phone. So that's that. Once you've chosen this, as you can see, it loaded up all my games here. You can have it like this or you can have it listed like this, depending how you like it, yeah? And in this case, I'm gonna show you how, for example, Tekken 6 is working. Let's check Tekken 6. Yeah, also when you're setting up your controls, you can choose to let them on your screen, to let them be visible on your screen. I don't like it to be visible on my screen. Only when I touch the screen like this, they pop up automatically because I'm using my controller and I don't need those. Okay. So let's press start. Now they are on my screen because I touched it. Let's choose an arcade battle. Let's use a harang. As you can see here, it's on playing now on around 60 frames per second. Now the game starts, becomes a fixed 60 frames, 62. Let's see. Yeah. So see, I'm playing now and the game stays at 60 frames per second. It's very smooth and very nice graphics. A lot better than it used to be on the PSP itself. And like this, you can enjoy all your old school games, yeah? Now, the good thing is here, if you would like to, for example, save in-game, a separate save file, you can press this button. And here you have different save states. So you can save just in the middle of a fight or wherever you are. And you can also use cheats, you see? If the cheats here are not enabled in the settings, you can enable the cheats, okay? So, this was Tekken on 60 frames. Let us check another one so you can see. Let's test another game. For example, let's test FIFA Street 2. Here's FIFA Street 2, press start. That's what I actually used to like about these old games. You could press a couple buttons and start very fast. So as you can see, this game is a fixed 30 frames per second game. But it plays very smooth and also a lot better graphics than the original. To show you the difference, this is how the original was. Put it on one time PSP. This is how the original was versus the new one. And this is upscaled again, you see? So there's a big difference and it works just fine. Okay, voila. So as you can see, that's it. It's very easy to set it up. It's completely free. You can use your original PlayStation 4, 5, or even an Xbox controller if you like. And you can get all your game backups online wherever you want. And you can do it all with your phone. You don't need the PC. You don't need to root your phone. I hope you like this tutorial. If you like more tutorials like this, and if you would like to see my next video, I'm gonna show you how to emulate a PlayStation console and play with two controllers at the same time. Then subscribe to the video, and I'm glad to see you in the next time. Thank you and have a nice one.